What is up everybody? So today I'm going to be showing all of you how I grind. So I'm making this video because I'm not going to really be grinding that much anymore. I will when the next update comes out. So I just figured why not share how I grind. So I'm going to show you two methods, which is one a manual method, which is the faster method, and one an AFK method, which is still really fast, but just a little bit slower than the manual method. And the AFK method you can run all day if you want to. Alright, so first I'll show you the manual. So basically, when you spawn in, you're just going to want to teleport to the fencing quest. Grab it. Oh, by the way, for this method you need to have demon. This is the best method, by the way. And then you're going to just want to fly up, go fetch him with the E move. So you're going to need a lot of strength, but if you can't do it with that move, it's okay. You can just use the C move or something. Just be a little bit slower. I think you only need like around 1 trillion strength though to launch him with it. But for the AFK method, you're gonna actually have to have 1 trillion strength, or you won't really need a whole lot. And you also have to have demons. So the AFK method does demand more, but if you can get up to that, then it's gonna be worth it because you're gonna be able to get super strong super fast. I found that. If I leave it running overnight, I get about 2 to 2.5 trillion strength a week. So it's really powerful. And this manual method gets you around 250 billion strength per hour. Maybe more. I haven't actually done this in a while, so it could give a lot more. I just don't know. Actually, it might give more like 300 billion. Yeah, it probably does give 100 billion. And the AFK method gives around 250 billion per hour. Alright, so now I've showed that one. So now I'm going to show the AFK method. This is kind of why I'm making this video. This is what I've been using since I hit 1 trillion strength. I've told a lot of people about it, but it's really not that popular yet. It is in the top reward players, but not a lot of people know about it. So I'm going to be sharing this with all of you. So that if you guys want to get 2 trillion strength and want to climb the leaderboard, this is going to be the best method to do it. Alright, so the first thing you're going to need is Tiny Test. Or, you could use other macro recorders, I just haven't really tested with them. But, you're going to need to make a macro with this. And how you're going to make it, you're going to have to do some specific things, otherwise it won't work. And I'm going to tell you the three things you can't do. You can't use Shift Lock. If you use Shift Lock, it'll mess up the macro. You also can't use Right Click to move your camera, and you also can't use scroll wheel to scroll on this. If you do any of those things, it'll mess up the macro because they don't register correctly in Tiny Test. So what you need to do instead is to scroll on this. You'll just use left click to scroll. And to turn your camera, you can use the arrow keys. So now that I have the basic rules down, I'm going to show you how I make a macro. I can make pretty good macros. I mean, I've been doing this for a long time. I make like a new macro every night just because too easy to save them, and when they do save them, they bug out a lot for some reason. Alright, so now when I load into the server, I'm going to want to leave a few seconds running, just so with fluctuating load times, it doesn't mess up my macro. Because let's say we do a slightly slower load time than my original, then the macro wouldn't work because it would run before I got fully loaded. So this is about 25 seconds. So pretty decent macro. And once again, I use the arrow keys to turn, like after I got the quest, I use my arrow keys to turn around and face Fetchdom. And then I teleported to Fetchdom. I flew up and didn't move my camera while flying. If you use right click while you're flying or shift lock or anything like that, it'll mess up the macro. Once you get like about halfway up the wall or a little bit higher halfway up the wall to Fetchdom, you're gonna want to click join server and then fly and kill the Fetchdom, because that will eliminate a couple seconds, like 1 or 2 seconds from your macro, so it helps save time. And now to show you guys that this actually works, I'm going to run the macro I just made. So yeah, I'm not doing anything around. I'm not going to be touching the keyboard or anything, and it's just going to run. And again, you can just leave this running overnight. And it's really powerful. There are a few things that can mess up, like there are a few errors you can, like, what was it? An error has occurred when joining the server. If that happens, I don't think it won't allow you to get into a new server, but, sometimes you can get a pop-up on your website that won't disappear for some reason, like the pop-up that appeared there. See, it normally disappears once you're in the server, but if you got, like, an error message while joining the server, it might not disappear. I'm not exactly sure, though, but I have gotten a few things that have plugged my micro overnight, but that's only happened a few times, or usually won't happen. I'd say it would happen, like, 1 out of 10 overnights that your micro will mess up. But overall, your macro will just keep running overnight and you get a ton of stats. And this is definitely the best farm method because you can leave it running for 12 hours straight, then wake up in the morning, you can play other games, you can do school stuff, and you don't really have to sit there and grind 12 hours to be high up on the leaderboard. So that's going to be it for the video. Hope you guys enjoy the method. I hope I can see some of you, get up there on the leaderboards and doing this. And thank you guys for watching. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you join the Discord in the description below. And peace. I also need to mention that you're going to want to click Windows key plus R and go into your temp folders by just clicking exclamation point temp, not exclamation point, percent temp percent. And then in here you'll see the Roblox folder and the RBX folders, which are what Roblox creates. After every overnight, I usually delete these because after a while, if these build up, they can cause performance drops in Roblox. So you just go and delete these every now and then. Just delete them here. Alright, so I deleted all the Roblox stuff, so that's good. Usually there'd be a lot more, but I haven't done grinding in the past few days. So that's it. Just a little thing that can be helpful.